This secret strategy will help you to identify support and resistance levels with just 3 simple steps. And look no further, because that technique works perfectly on Forex, gold, stocks, and crypto. Tutors, please don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and let's start. Step number 1. Open a daily time frame of a financial instrument that you want to analyze, and then zoom out the chart and make sure that you see the price action for the last 6 months. Step number 2, identify the low and the high of the visual range. On the price chart, identify the lowest low and draw the horizontal line, and identify the highest high and draw the horizontal line based on that. Step number 3, identify key levels. In order to do that, start with the low and go through all the points on a price chart from where there were important bullish or bearish movements in the past. Our today's sponsor is Top Trading Signals. Get exclusive free forecasts and signals in his Telegram channel. Subscribe now, the link in the description below. The first important level on focus is, of course, the level of the current low. From the level of the current low, we saw a strong bullish movement. Then a bit higher over here, we have one more, very important level. And you can see that 2 times in the past, from that we saw a significant bullish rally. In the recent past, the market bounced, and 6 months ago, the market bounced nicely from that shift. The next important level is over here. You can see that in the past, from that structure, we saw significant moves. And then we go higher, over here, one more structure, and you can see that many times the market respected that horizontal level. From that horizontal level, we saw significant bullish and bearish movements. Then, over here, one more, then we go higher, and we have a significant structure here and here. Then we have a lot of levels right here, lying very close to each other. Right here, we have important level, and right here, we have a very important horizontal structure. And of course, the level of the current high is also very important, because in the past, from that structure, a very strong bearish movement initiated. Here we identified a lot of structures, we identified a lot of key levels, and of course, some of these key levels are invalid, and your next task will be to identify the invalid structures. But what is the invalid structure? Invalid structure is the structure that was important for the market participants in the past. However, with time, that structure lost its significance. And what do I mean by lost the significance? I mean that the structure should be invalidated both by the sellers and by the buyers, so that when sellers test that, we don't see the reaction from that structure. And then when buyers test that, we don't see any reaction to that structure. Here is the example. So you can see that we have a very strong structure right here that was respected many times by the market. However, take a look at the recent price action. If we analyze the recent price action, we can see that that structure was easily broken by the sellers, and we haven't seen any reaction from that. And then we saw a strong bullish movement, and bulls violated that structure, and we haven't seen the reaction to that structure. So that structure lost its significance. It is invalid, so we take that away from our chart. And a bit higher, we have similar structures. Take a look at these 2 levels. Again, many times in a row, they were respected by the market. But recent price action is always more important. And if we consider the recent price action, we can spot that these 2 levels were invalidated by the sellers and by the buyers. So we take away the structures from our chart. Now, if we zoom in the chart and analyze the price action for the last 2 weeks, we can spot more invalid structures. You can see that these 2 structures right here were invalidated both by the buyers and by the sellers. So we remove them. And similar thing with that structure. You can see that it was invalidated by the sellers and then by the buyers. So the recent price action clearly indicates that that structure is no more significant for the mortgage participants. So we remove that. Few structures are left. And now it is finally the moment to underline the structure zones, to underline supply and demand zones. And in order to do that, first of all, you should identify the structures that are lying close to each other. For example, here we have two levels lying very close to each other. We unite them in one single area. Same thing is over here. You can see that we have two key levels lying very close to each other. So we unite them in one single area. Then traders, remember this very important rule. When you draw a support, make sure that the upper boundary of your support is based on the lowest candle close within that area, while the lower boundary of your support should be the lowest wick. A similar rule will be applied with the resistance. When you draw a resistance, the upper boundary of the resistance will be the highest wick, while the lower boundary of the resistance will be the highest candle close within the zone. Now let's make sure that we draw our structure zones properly. Here is our zone of support, and its lower boundary should be strictly based on the lowest wick, while its upper boundary should be the lowest candle close. So that will be our support zone. Then right here, the upper boundary of our zone underlined correctly based on the highest wick, while its lower boundary should be extended. You can see that our highest candle close is over here. So that would be our horizontal zone, our horizontal demand zone. Then take a look at that structure right here. So first of all, its lower boundary will be the lowest wick. But where will be its upper boundary? It will be based on the lowest candle close. So that is going to be your resistance area. Then this structure right here, again, its upper boundary will be the highest wick and its lower boundary will be the highest candle close. And finally, our high, we follow the same rule as the upper boundary of the zone. We take the highest wick and the lower boundary of the zone will be the highest candle close. And now a couple of words about the manipulations. You can see that here we got a strong bull run and the market almost reached our resistance, and then we saw a very strong rejection. Because of the manipulation, the market didn't manage to reach that structure. And in such a situation, when the market almost touched the key level, I highly recommend to extend your structure and to take into consideration that test. And the same thing is over here. You can see that the market was falling and we almost reached our structure. We almost touched that. So drawing that zone, let's take into consideration that test. And these are the most important key levels that we identified on gold. And these structures you can apply for trading. These key levels will be the safest points from where you can look for shorting the market or for buying the market. Traders, let me know in the comment section if you have any questions. Also, let me know if you want to see more videos about structure analysis. Traders, please don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and do not forget to watch my other videos.